Concentration. This fight is scheduled for 5 3-minute rounds. 5 means that it's for the Fierce Fighting Championship Amateur Lightweight title. Introducing the first fighter to the cage out of the blue corner. He holds an amateur record of 6 wins and 3 losses, and he weighed in at 152.5 pounds. He's fighting out of Legion MMA and Siege MMA and Fitness. Fierce fans, make some noise and welcome to the cage, the Honey Badger, Alim Muhammed.
Well, after 5 canceled bouts over the course of 11 months, Alim Muhammed makes the way to the cage for the first time since October 13th of 2019. The Legion MMA lightweight feels more focused and prepared than ever before, which will be necessary as he enters his 5th championship bout in 4 years. Joel, it's been quite some time since his last MMA bout, October 2019 to be exact, but he has been around the gym a whole lot. Do you think there could be any ring rust considering his time away, but also his consistency in the gym?
Absolutely not. To me, I don't think ring rust is a thing. It's all in your preparation. If you're training hard, he comes from a good gym, so I believe that he's been training on that time off and getting better. So he's going to come in here and do what he does best and give it all he's got.
The 6-3 lightweight out of Legion MMA. And actually, it's his first fight at lightweight since May of 2018. He has typically been a featherweight in the past. You've got to wonder what that's going to look like at a new weight class. We've got a few of those here tonight.
Yeah, I'm really curious to see how he looked. From the weigh-ins last night, I believe he's going to be the smaller fighter inside the cage tonight. We'll find out. He looks super confident. He's in shape, and he's got a ton of experience in these types of fights. So it's going to be a great fight.
4 title fights in his amateur career that has dated back to 2015. He is Alim Muhammed. Right now we're going to bring out the other side, Will Dean.
And introducing his opponent. Fighting out of the red corner, he holds an undefeated amateur record of 4 wins and 0 losses. And he weighed in at 155 pounds, fighting out of Akima, Jiu-Jitsu, and MMA. Fierce fans, make some noise and welcome to the cage, the reigning, defending, amateur lightweight champion, Willie Vanilli William Dean!
Coming off of one of the most exciting comebacks of the year, the champion returns in hope of his first title defense. Enter Will Dean of Agema Jiu-Jitsu. The lightweight has faced the who's who en route to his championship belt, including Malachi Novosel, Brian Rios, Zane Darlington, Jason. For those who saw his last performance, it's going to take a lot to take this belt away from Will Dean.
That was a phenomenal performance. He was easily losing the first 2 rounds. Came back. He's always in phenomenal shape. He's a technical fighter. He trains out of one of the top gyms in Utah. I expect a lot from Will Dean tonight.
He is
Willie Vanilli Dean tonight. Sorry to interrupt you there, Blake.
You're all right. You're all right. No easy fights throughout his 4-0 career so far. The combined record of his opponents is 8-2. I mean, he has faced the who's who to get here to this fight tonight to defend his title for the first time. He is Will Dean. And I mean, Joel, you remember what it was like at Mountain View High School back in May. What a performance he put on.
Oh, man. That was an amazing performance that he put on. Like Jason said, he was losing the first couple rounds, and then comes out of nowhere, starts touching his opponent up, and then bam, knocks him out. So I mean, if he may take this first round just to feel him out and see what he's up against, but I expect nothing but fireworks from Mr. Willie Vanilli himself.
Will Dean in his second ever championship bout. Alim Muhammed in his 5th. He is 2-2 in his championship amateur fight so far. Over at featherweight, Will Dean enters the cage here tonight for Agema Jiu-Jitsu. Alim Muhammed out of Legion MMA in Phoenix, Arizona. And this fight might have Fight of the Night written all over it.
Yeah, I agree with you on that one, Blake. Both fighters looking focused and ready.
No, actually, now that I'm looking at Alim after those weigh-ins last night, it looks like he's filled out pretty well. He probably started. He's probably a younger fighter and filled out into that frame as the years went by.
This bout is scheduled for 5 3-minute rounds, considering it is for a championship belt. Alim Muhammed in the blue, Will Dean in the camo. Is that camo?
It is,
yes,
camo.
Sir.
Just want to make sure.
I like those shorts. Those are nice.
Nice leg kicks coming from Willie Vanilli.
Alim Muhammed's first fight since October 10th of 2019 at a new weight class for the belt.
I like how active Will's being in this first round right now.
Both fighters 5'11". The nice blitz there is Alim Muhammed. Will Dean now searching to apply some pressure up against the cage.
Yeah, now he's looking for that takedown. Looking to get a single there. But Alim defends really well.
He's doing a great job.
Now looking to toss.
Alim, a fantastic wrestler himself, a regional champ back in high school.
Willie going back for that single leg there.
He might have it.
Searching for potentially the ankle pick there as well.
Trying to run the pipe, but Alim with his good wrestling defense there.
He's off the cage.
Yeah, he's off.
Will Dean had him lifted off the cage.
Looks like he was holding on the fence there a little bit.
He's doing it again, too.
Yep.
Down goes Alim Muhammed. Will Dean able to land the first takedown of the night? Alim Muhammed right back up.
Got one hook in.
This is a dangerous place to be for Alim with Will Dean on your back this early into the first round.
Oh,
Will,
yeah.
Will Dean, a blue belt in Brazilian jiu-jitsu. Alim Muhammed, all three losses in his amateur career have come by submission. One triangle, one guillotine, and then one other that was unspecified. Searching for that seatbelt grip is Will Dean. Fighting that first hook is Alim. And Alim being able to stay on his feet, Joel. I mean, it's pretty unbelievable so far that he's still upright.
Yeah, he's a good wrestler for sure. His takedown defense is on point. And he gets out.
Back to the striking exchange as we go. Big overhand right thrown by Alim there, and Alim also had some kickboxing
matches.
Looks
like a front choke. I'm going to start calling Will Willie now.
Willie
Vanilli. I like his nickname.
Now we're seeing Alim on the back of Will.
Alim with one submission in his amateur career back in September of 2018. Interesting performance, a lot of feeling out, but also going to show that it is quite an evenly matched matchup and a technical one between these two lightweights.
Yeah, this is what you want to see in a title fight. You want to see two evenly matched guys in here, or ladies, fighting for that title.
We just saw in the corner of Will Dean his brother Andrew Dean, who also is an amateur fighter. He is 5-1, and he's performed here for Fierce Fighting Championship in the past as well, Jason.
Yes, he has, and he's looked phenomenal. I wonder when we're going to get him back.
It's been quite some time, actually, since he's fought. I believe he's only had one fight this year. I think it was earlier on. I actually don't have the record of that, but.
No way, Blake. You don't have the record
for
that?
You don't have the record?
I apologize. I apologize to everyone at home watching.
Hey, Blake is the most prepared.
And Alim Muhammed, I wanted to mention this as well. He has a 6-3 record, but he has other MMA matches on his social media that date back further than his debut. I'm not sure what the record is there. I'm not sure how that came to be. I just wanted to mention that as I am talking about his record and his past fights as well. Second of a potential 5 3-minute rounds. And Alim hasn't been throwing a whole lot, but when he does, he's very quick, Joel. He's got a snappy jab and a snappy right hook as well.
Yeah, his jab's looking phenomenal tonight.
Nice check. Alim seems to have a little bit of a speed advantage on the feet.
Yeah, I was going to say, I feel like he's a little bit quicker than Will right now.
Alim Muhammed had a 5-fight win streak from June of 2018 to October of 2018.
likes that outside leg kick.
Oh, Will just ate a big right hand.
Down the pipe is Alim Muhammed. Will returns with a head kick. Blocked by Muhammed.
With their shots.
Well, they got five rounds.
Yeah, they got five rounds. No reason to rush anything and get caught into something.
I mean, both of these guys have to be knocking on the door to the pro ranks here shortly.
Oh, absolutely. They look really good as high-level amateurs right now, too.
Dean coming up on the three-year anniversary of his fight debut as an amateur. Back in January of 2020, Alim Muhammed, 7.5 years as a fighter again. His first fight in 3 years here tonight. A nice leg kick landed there by Muhammed.
We saw a little bit of this in Dean's last fight, where he was a little slow in that first and second round. Oh, he just ate a right hand by Alim Muhammed.
Nice body kick to the body. He went. Alim Muhammed down goes
shot.
Will Dean potentially. Able to stay up is Dean, but putting on the pressure is Alim Muhammed. Going to the body once again, and now
looks like he's got a choke.
Locked up in maybe a guillotine. It's kind of hard to see from here in the broadcast booth.
Ooh, heavy knees to the body.
And a knee landed as well.
Alim was invested in those body shots in that first round, and there was a kick in the beginning of this first round that I thought hurt Willie Dean, too.
I like how patient Alim is being here. He's obviously got the control against the fence, but picking his knees very wisely there.
A couple of devastating knees landed there to close out round number two for Alim Muhammed. What a turn of events here. I mean, what was a slow round turned into absolute domination to close out round number two.
Oh, absolutely. And Alim doesn't even look tired.
No, Alim looks fresh. And like I said, we saw Dean in a bad position in that title fight against Zane Darlington, and he came back and ended up getting the knockout. So we know he's going to be in here for the long haul.
It looked like Will might have been hurt to the body, Joel.
Yeah,
did you see that?
Like that kick did some damage to him. But like I've mentioned before in the past, never count out somebody from Agema, and especially Willie Vanilli.
I would guess Alim's corner is telling him to invest in that body again after what they saw in that second round.
Most likely going to be a part of the game plan here. Third of a potential five rounds here. And we saw Will kind of fold just a little bit,
just
and I thought he was about to get dropped.
He did.
He ended up not dropping.
Way to weather the storm.
This is where that championship fight experience could come into play for Alim. Having four championship title fights under his belt already.
Both fighters staying calm, trying to pick their shots.
Very calculated as both fighters.
It seems like the speed of Alim is giving Will Dean
Yeah, that is especially one frustrating thing in a fight is when someone's quicker than you and you try to time your shots, but they're gone as you're getting hit. Not fun.
I'll save that for you, Joel.
We saw a little bit of fainting there by Alim Muhammed. A nice body kick landed as well.
Ooh, good right hand.
Cracking right hand. Straight down the pipe is Alim Muhammed.
Oh, and a big left,
solid
by,
left
Willie
hand by Willie Dean.
And that was the same left hand that dropped Zane Darlington in the fourth round in his last fight, Jason.
Alim looks fresh. Doesn't even look like it bothered him. Really impressed with the composure of Alim Muhammed in this fight.
Nice body kick.
There you go.
good matchup.
Nice head kick. Landed by Muhammed. Leg kick landed as well. A little less juice on that one. And more juice there as Alim Muhammed in the return. To the body, Alim went once again.
Alim is mixing up his striking very well. Body, head, leg.
Something he's definitely been focusing on as of recent.
Nice leg kick.
Alim switching stances.
Final 10 seconds here of round number 3. Talking back is Alim Muhammed and returns a couple of his own. Will Dean all smiles going in to round number 4. It's good to see from the two so far because there's been some punishing blows, but to see the two smiling jumping into round number 4.
Oh, yeah.
Does.
Not even breathing heavy, man.
No.
For 3 years away and to come up here to Salt Lake City, I mean, you have to wonder how much cardio he had in this training camp.
Yeah, he looks phenomenal tonight. I'd like to see Willie D be a little bit more active, maybe use that jab a little bit more. But once again, Alim Muhammed, he's just phenomenal. He's quick. He's fast. He's going to the body. He's going to the head.
Joel, are you seeing that Alim is very tough to hit? Because it seems like Will is not throwing as much as he typically does in the volume that he typically does.
Oh, for sure. I mean, if you pay attention to Alim's style, like he's coming in, doing his shots, and then getting out as fast as he can. By the time Will returns, he's already out of his range and already onto his next attack.
Fourth round is upon us.
And Alim looks like he's just coming out. He looks like he's barely breaking a sweat, and he's ready to go for this fourth round. This is where we saw Willie Dean turn it up in his last fight, though.
Oh, nice lead uppercut.
Able to weather the storm is Will Dean there.
Oh, nice.
Ooh, big shot to the body there, and another knee landed. By Alim Muhammed there.
Just kind of measuring each other in this fourth round.
Trying to keep that lead hand active to open up that right hand.
Another devastating knee to the body landed, but Will returns a couple to the head as well.
You can hear both corners yelling instructions out to their fighters.
Nice inside leg kick.
Blake, I think you nailed it earlier in this round. It seems like when Alim's throwing, Will goes to fire back. Alim's out of the way.
He's already gone, and so it's been tough for Will to get some offense going. And I'm going to say Joel Haro was the one that actually said that. He's the one with the cage experience here, Jason.
Yeah, that's my fault there.
Nice left hook from Alim there.
A little low kick there by Alim, a little touch of the gloves. Don't count out Will Dean.
Never count him out, man.
Very similar to what was going on with Zane Darlington. I would say Zane Darlington had landed more.
Oh, that body shot.
To the body once again is Alim, and that has been his bread and butter all night.
Very impressed with Alim Muhammed tonight.
I feel like Will is a little hesitant.
Those body shots, I think, have kind of added up through those rounds.
Yeah, absolutely.
sweat fly from Alim. I don't know if that landed from Dean. Doesn't matter because he's marching forward still.
Let's see if Will can get a takedown here at the last 10 seconds.
To the takedown. Attempted there, but just another knee to close out the fourth round. The final round of this championship bout coming up. And Joel, I mean, it's been Alim Muhammed for the majority of this fight. Rounds 2 through 4 have really been all for the lightweight out of Legion MMA.
Yeah, I feel like Alim is just a step ahead of Will, you know. He's definitely a lot faster than him. He's getting in and out. He's putting on a phenomenal performance here. Let's see what he's going to do in this fifth round. I'd like to see Will come out and do some damage here.
For a couple stats here, Alim Muhammed with 2 unanimous decisions. He's got 1 split decision win. He's got 1 submission win as well as 2 TKOs. As for Will Dean, he's got a rear naked choke win, a TKO win, a unanimous decision, and then in his last fight, we all know the story, the fourth round knockout of Zane Darlington. So, pretty well-rounded fighters in terms of finishes. Last time for the decision for Alim Muhammed was October 10th of 2019, his last fight. Last time for Will Dean was February 12th of this year.
Alim looks fresh. He is in phenomenal shape. And Willie Dean is as well. More activity from Willie Deans to start off this fifth and final round.
Yeah. Coming out more intentional, I feel like.
And you've got to wonder if Dana Rissazabal was saying, we need the finish here, so we need you to throw as much as you possibly can.
Oh, absolutely.
Oh, nice body shot.
To the body he goes once again as Alim Muhammed.
There's that left hand again. A little more urgency from Willie Dean this round.
Yeah, hard leg kick there.
You can hear Aleem's corner saying that Willie Dean is overcommitting and that straight is there for him. We'll see if he's listening.
Yeah.
He throws it.
I feel like he's going to pop out and shoot that right hand down the middle if he overextends again. I think Alim is seeing it. I feel like he's just going to choose the perfect time to act on it.
Yeah, he's waiting.
Both fighters searching for the finishing blows, and it looks like they've been kind of doing that for the last couple of rounds.
Hey, and then he goes back to the body with that right hand.
I'm loving this body work by Alim Muhammed.
He's jabbing high and following through with that right hook to the body. Beautiful.
They're talking to each other in the cage there.
A couple of compliments from Alim Muhammed towards Will Dean's way. We're under a minute left here in round number 5.
There's that straight. You can see Aleem's confidence now. What a great performance by Alim Muhammed tonight. Oh, big head kick.
High kick. Also got to give credit to Will here. He's still answering back. Still coming forward. Oh, a nice shot.
Final 10 seconds here. Alim Muhammed looking to finish with a stamp of approval. With a takedown there.
Looking up at the clock. Great fight.
That will do it. What a performance.
Both guys.
Oh,
almost broke his neck, but hey.
Yeah, that was almost as bad.
Congratulations.
Oh, there it is. There it is.
Little backflip to throw it off. What a performance by Alim Muhammed after 3 years off to come back and look like that. And, Joel, you said it at the beginning of the fight. You don't believe in ring rust. We definitely didn't see any right there.
Oh, definitely not. We could definitely see that Alim's been working hard in his layoff, and his hard work definitely paid off tonight. His boxing was nice and crisp. Those body shots.
Lots of work to the body was Alim Muhammed. Will D just never really able to get any offense going, never really got any solidified combinations going either. But you've got to wonder what the future is for Will Dean. I mean, he has made everyone in his path so far regret fighting him, so you've got to wonder what he's going to do in the near future.
Hey, man, you got to go back to the drawing board. You learn from this fight, you get better. He's going to come back. He's going to come back stronger. And I'm sure this fight's going to make him hungry to come back to get the title again.
Love between the two right here. Quick handshake between the two as well. For the lightweight amateur belt for Fierce Fighting Championship.
And here we go. New champion is crowned.
After five rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. All three judges score this contest 49-46, 50-45, and 50-45 for your winner, declaring the winner by unanimous decision and new amateur lightweight champion, the Honey Badger, Alim Muhammed.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm here with your winner, Mr. Alim Muhammed. Alim, you come up here to Utah. You have a dominant performance against an undefeated fighter. You take the title. Tell us how you're feeling tonight.
Grateful, honored, and grateful. I'll double down on that. Grateful to be back in here. It's been 3 years out of the cage. I became a father about 2 years ago. COVID followed up right after that. So I've been trying, man. I've been trying. I'm a 145-pounder. We searched the country this year, man, the last 7 months for a fight. Shout out to William Dean, undefeated fighter, putting his title on the line against a fighter coming up. I'm just grateful to be back in here, to be competing and doing what I love. I want to thank Richie out of Roman Institute. He's one of the matchmakers for setting me up. I want to thank my man Jackson, and I want to thank my man right here, what's the promoter's name? Zach. Thank you guys for the opportunity. I can't fucking wait to be back here and performing for you guys on the pro side of the card here in the next year.
So is that the plan now? Are you going to go pro, or do you want to defend your title?
100%. Y'all can have this shit back. I'll get a picture. I wanted to go pro. If I had it my way, I'd have been fighting pro tonight. My coaches were adamant on me shaking off the rust, getting the experience back, and we're ready to turn the page, man. I've been competing in this cage under the unified rule set since I was 15. April will be 12 years. It's nine sanctions fights coming in here, but that's because Michigan didn't sanction amateur fighting before 2012. This is my 17th amateur fight. It's time to turn the page. I'm ready to get paid, go to the next level.
I think you're ready for it, Alim Muhammed. Everybody, give it up for your winner and new Fierce Fighting Championship, light heavyweight champion, Mr. Alim Muhammed.